Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. So here I'm going to tell you how these Messianic Jews, they hypocritically, using their sycophant power, lured simple-minded people whose hearts Christ Jesus has cleansed with his blood. He spilled his innocent blood, and those robbers which were hanged with him, they also testified, "We have done something wrong, but Christ Jesus has done no wrong. He is innocent blood being spilled." So all over the country, people with the clean heart, which were mostly there, because Middle East is not that bad as in East, so over there, most of the people, we can say 95% of the Middle East people, they were lamenting for the innocent blood being spilled by those temple rabbis. So they were no more want to know those temple rabbis. They were crook. Only 5% who were stupid and who you could do anything to them. They have been told that this is your temple and you have to come here and this is your this and that. As people in India, those people who are calling themselves Sikhs have beard and turban. I have put this thing, you know, which we call the star. These people say that I'm not a Sikh, you know, the people of India. So to tell them I'm a Sikh, you know, so put this the star on. So these people, you know, who are calling themselves Sikhs in India of beard and turban have learned next to nothing. So if they are told, you know, this Harmandir Sahib is our most sacred place and you must give your sacrifice for it, and they will go for it without thinking. So this Harmandir now that was in is in Amritsar, but gold has to do with God. Those crook Sodhi Khatris, they put gold on it to fleece people. So you can see how the simpletons are fleeced all over the world. So Middle East was not an exception, but in the Middle East and in the West, people have much cleaner hearts. Over there, they lament when some innocent blood is spilled. And you can see, if there's injustice done in the West, you know, and how people raise petitions and get the justice done. Whereas if you are in India and injustice is done to you, nobody bothers. They even laugh at you when you petition. So the West has a much nicer and softer heart for Christ to come in. But these are psychic or sycophant who are clever people who go for money. They are many. The workers of God are very few. One in 1,000, two in 10,000. Whereas these psychic who go for Mammon, like Judas Iscariot, they are more than 10% of the population. They go for that. So these Messianic Jews to whom this people of Judah tribe, to whom this Dark Age belongs, because the prophet comes among those people to whom the Dark Age belongs. That means this is the age of crooks. So Judah people were the most crook people of all the chosen people. So from the Judea region, then they expelled the apostles that I have explained earlier. And now if you remember the story, that when St. Paul was presented before King Agrippa I hope I'm saying right, you know. I don't read much. King Agrippa to explain and to accuse him. So these temple priests from the Jerusalem, then they bring in a special man who could address the king in a very humble and sycophant way. Now the way in which he presents is the same it is as today is the fashion in the courts. The judges and other people, you know, they are public servants. And these solicitors, what they call them? My lord, my lord. My lord, they are your servant and you call them my lord. So this is the type of language these sycophants speak that boost the ego of the judge or of the king. So these temple priests, they took a special man to present their case against St. Paul. But St. Paul won't say my lord or anything, he will just say you are a good king, as the truth is, because Romans were good king. So they loved justice, you know, they don't want to tarnish their name. But the Jewish people, they have no salt of the earth. They were salt of the earth. That's why they were ruling over the other. Same in India, we had the Mughals who had the salt of the earth. They ruled. When they became saltless, they were changed over by the English. And today our people, you can see how saltless they are. So what I mean to say that most of these people whose hearts Christ has cleansed with his blood, you know, innocent blood, they were once born. And these psychic people who went for money and power, they were more than those who went for God. So this is the doubting stage. So these psychic people who say, my Lord and all that, they made a pact with the Roman Emperor Constantine that those people who oppose us, please get rid of them and we will supply you soldiers from here, once born people who don't know what they are doing. They are like pawn, are used by these psychic people. Wherever they put, they go. As in churches and other places, you see them, how these people, you know, what their dog-collar minister tell them, they do. They don't want to listen to you. They only listen to him. So this is the situation. They put on these fanciful robes, as you see them in these Russian bishops and these Orthodox people, they put on very costly robes. So those robes, they have a great impression on these once-born people. On these who are sold, sealed to serve God, they laugh at those people. And when they laugh, they get annoyed. As they got annoyed with me, in Romania, Cluj, these so-called fathers, they were putting on these robes, and then I told them, you know what robes you are putting, you have to give your own account to God. So everyone has to give his own account to God. So you are Antichrist. And also those who are taking money, I told them, how can you expect payment from God when you expect payment in Mammon? So they were not happy either. So both of them were not happy, but as you know, the West people are cooler in temperament. So I was not afraid. And whenever you work for God, you have put your cross, you carry your cross of affliction, hatred, and other things. So you should be happy that you are being crowned by these afflictions. So God bless you.